Welcome, I'm Ben Spencer from Lightray Creative Digital, and I wanted to let you know about an update to my node pack, SDF Nodebox. If you're not familiar, SDF Nodebox is a pack of shader nodes for Blender that lets you easily create and manipulate sign distance fields, which you can think of as really flexible procedural shape gradients that can also act like metaballs and can do a bunch of other stuff too. They're very useful. This update contains three new nodes: Grid Slide Regular, Grid Slide Custom, and Masked UV Offset Slide, plus a minor addition to Repeat Infinite and Repeat Finite. Starting with the minor update to the repeat nodes, to get that out of the way, I've added a normalize slider which, when set to 1, will normalize the UVs inside each cell so that they range from negative 1 to 1. By default, when it's set to 0, the repeat nodes won't affect the scale of the UVs so they don't have any effect on the size of any SDFs that you add in after. But creating a grid that has a full UV space in each cell is a common situation, so I've added in this slider to allow for that. Moving on to the first of the new nodes, Grid Slide Regular, which is named regular as in regular spacing, will allow you to shift or slide rows or columns at regular intervals. For example, if I set the row spacing to 2, every second row will be affected. And then if I bring the row slide offset up to 0.5, each of those affected rows will be slid half a cell to the right, giving us the same alternating grid that we created as part of the Snake Scales video. Going over the inputs, the grid vector and grid cell ID should be connected to the vector and cell ID output respectively of the repeat infinite or repeat finite nodes, as you can see here. Next is the spacing. These inputs control how often a row or column should be affected. Set as it is now at 2, every other row is affected. But if I bring this up to 3, then it's every third row. At 4, it becomes every fourth row, and so on. The column input works the same, but for columns. The offset sockets are just how far each row or column should be slid. With the row offset set to 0.5, all of the affected rows will have been slid half a cell to the side, but if I drag this value around, you can see the rows sliding. The last and most confusing input is the intersection type. This node allows you to add offsets for both rows and columns, but if you're using both, you'll need to decide what happens to the cells that are in both the affected rows and columns. By default, at option 0, it does nothing and uses neither offset. Option 1 tells it to use only the row offset. Option 2 uses only the column offset. And if you set it to 3, it'll apply both the rows and column offsets. Looking at the outputs of the node, you have the UV space output, but you also have masks for both the affected rows and columns if you need to single them out. The next node, the Grid Slide Custom, does the same thing as the Grid Slide Regular, but this is the node you want to use if you need something more custom to your situation than regular spacing. For example, alternating double rows, or maybe you want to shift only the rows in this custom hexagon mask. The difference between the Grid Slide Custom and the Grid Slide Regular is that you define your own masks, that you provide the node for which rows and columns should be affected. The last of the new nodes, the Masked UV Offset Slide node, allows you to shift around a masked area within a UV space. Your UVs go into the vector input, and the mask input is just the masked area you want to be affected. And then the offset amount is how far the masked area should be shifted. The last part is the Per Channel Offset Slide switch. This lets you decide how you want your offsets to behave. When it's set to offset, which is 0 or all the way to the left, it will act directly as just an offset, as if the coordinates inside the masked area had been shifted over by that amount. Set to slide, which is 1 or all the way to the right, is probably most useful when using this inside of a grid. This keeps all the values inside the negative 1 to 1 range, creating the same sliding effect as the grid offset slide nodes, just localized inside the mask you defined. And you can decide this on a per channel basis, so you can set your X channel to slide and your Y channel to offset. As an example for how you can use these nodes, we can recreate the custom UV space we created in the procedural Snake Scales video with just 6 nodes. First, we'll create our initial grid with a repeat infinite node, set to be normalized, and with a spacing of 0.1. Then we can create the alternating grid with the grid slide regular node, setting the row spacing to 2 so that every second row is affected, and then setting the row slide offset to 0.5 so that they're shifted half a cell to the side. Next, we'll need to mask out the area we want to look like a continuation of the lower row cells. For that, I'll use a 2D circle SDF, and then a SDF to mask node. Then to get the right shape, I'll bring the radius up to 1 and the Y scale to 2. I can then move it into the lower corner by setting the location to 1, negative 1. Now we only have half of our mask, so we'll add in a mirror axes node before our circle 2D node, which will add in the other half we need. We'll use this as the mask for our masked UV offset slide node, so I'll add in one of those and plug in our coordinate space and our mask. Then, to create a continuation of the cells below, we want to offset our y value by 2. Then, for our x value, we don't want to offset it, but rather we want to slide it back half a cell to line up with the row below. So, we want to set our offset slide switch for our x channel to 1, and then I'll set the x offset to 0.5, which lines everything up to create our custom UV space with only 6 nodes. If you want to learn more about SDF Nodebox, I'll leave a link in the description to the tutorial playlist I created. And if you're interested in purchasing SDF Nodebox, I'll also leave links to where you can do that as well. If you enjoyed this video, you can tell both me and YouTube that by liking and subscribing. And if you have any questions, comments, or requests, I'll be happy to answer them in the comments. Or you can join our newly created channel Discord. Again, the invite is in the description. Thanks for sticking around to the end. I'll see you next time.